Good evening. Graham Polly Farmer, one of the greatest ever footballers to play the game, has died. The 84-year-old, who passed away in Perth, is being remembered as a pioneer of ruck work, his power helping Geelong to a Premiership in 1963. Tony Jones with this tribute.
At a time when terms like champion and legend are bandied around all too freely, Polly Farmer rightfully lays claim to both.
Farmer's on the halfback flank. Look at that mighty hand pass over here.
Born in Fremantle in 1935, Graham Farmer would soon become known as Polly.
So I was probably 6 or 7 years of age. Boys and girls started calling me Polly the Parrot. They said that I chatted too much. Most people today wouldn't think that would be right, but in those days it may have been right, and it just stuck.
There would be no easy passage to stardom for Farmer. Shipped from home to home at the behest of the state, it was football that would provide Polly with the stability he so desperately craved.
It's all I wanted to do.
After taking all before him in Perth, where he endured the most despicable of racist taunts, Farmer and his young family moved to Victoria, and it was Geelong who welcomed him with open arms. That was 1962. In 1963, he was a Premiership star.
We'll start to feel the effects later on in the week. We can't believe it at the moment.
In many ways, Polly Farmer was a football revolutionary. He embarked on fitness campaigns never before seen. He turned handball into an art form, just as he did with ruck work. His protege was Sam Newman.
I have no hesitation in saying this. He is one of Australia's great role models, particularly for his Indigenous past and background.
Indeed, the Geelong Football Club is today among the many paying tribute to a man they so proudly call their own.
He was courageous enough to take a strong leadership role in a time when it must have been really tough for him and his people. And he did it with flying colours.
Having eventually cut ties with the Cats, Polly moved back to WA, where he again enjoyed the highest success. And it seemed for any Victorian making a trip west, a catch-up with Polly was a must. On this occasion, Lou Richards putting Polly's famous car window trick to the test.
One of the beauties of it, you know, you can keep practising and occasionally you may get it.
Unbelievable!
Farmer's retirement should have been stress-free. But for all his successes, the footy great fell on hard times. Financially, he struggled, mates rallying to help out.
Make no risk, Ablett was good, but he wasn't as good as the old GF, hey?
He also developed dementia. This 2013 reunion of his former East Perth teammates, one of his last appearances.
Polly Farmer.
Only a few months ago, Polly's daughter and grandson rang the bell at Cadinia Park. The legend was certainly there in spirit.
He's pretty old, he's 84. I don't think he ever thought he would live this long. And he's certainly at the end of his life, but because he's been so fit for all these years, his, you know, beautiful heart can't stop beating.
Such was his deteriorating health, Polly was unable to speak in his latter years. He didn't need to. His career speaks for itself. Tony Jones, Nine News.
Hi YouTubers, I'm Davina Smith. Well, click here to keep watching great Nine videos and subscribe to our channel here for lots more news, analysis and exclusive content. For breaking news, see you at ninenews.com.au.